Let us see some more examples in this kinematics section. A particle of mass 1 kg has a velocity of 2 meters per second. A constant force of 2 newton acts on the particle for 1 second in a direction perpendicular to its initial velocity. Find the velocity and the displacement of the particle at the end of 1 second. Now, whenever you see this term called constant force, it means that it is moving with constant acceleration, because force is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay, so the force is constant, mass anyway is constant, so acceleration also will be constant. Often you come across these kind of terms, so understand the meaning of that. Constant acceleration means you can use all those three kinematic equations. Okay, now what is the acceleration here? Force is 2, mass is 1, so it is 2 meter per second square. Now let us write these equations in the vector format. V vector is equal to u plus at, u vector plus a vector into t. So why vector symbol not put a time means? Time is not a vector, acceleration is a vector. If you see this, is it not, does it not look like addition of two vectors, like a vector plus b vector is equal to c vector? Okay, so here u vector is in the x direction, and in the question he says that it is perpendicular, you know, the particle for 1 second in a direction perpendicular to its initial velocity. Initial velocity was in this direction, perpendicular to initial, perpendicular to the initial velocity means 90 degrees to that. So what will be our v vector, which is the final velocity? It will be vector addition of these two vectors. Okay, so if you add this vector to this vector, you get this vector. But if you want to find the magnitudes, you have to take this geometry, which is a hypotenuse. So square of this side plus square of this side is equal to square of this side. Okay, so root over magnitude of u square plus magnitude of at square. So u is given as 2, so 2 square plus a we have got as 2, time after the end of 1 second is asking, so put e is equal to 1 here, so you get 2 into 1 whole square, so which is 2 root 2 meter per second. That is the answer. Okay, that means the velocity after 1 second is 2 root 2 meter per second. And can you tell the direction also? Yes, the direction also we can tell if you find this alpha value. So tan alpha will be opposite by adjacent. Opposite is 80, magnitude of 80. This symbol, this double straight lines means magnitude. We are taking only the magnitude. We are not bothered about the direction part. So 80 is 2 and u is also 2, 2 by 2, it is 1. So tan alpha is 1, that means alpha is making 45 degrees. So from the initial position, it is at a making an angle of 45 degrees. Now, the location is here. If this is east, this is north, this is in the northeast direction. So we have found out the velocity after 1 second. Now he wants us to find out the displacement with respect to the initial position. So this also let us see in the vector format. S vector is equal to u vector into t plus half into a vector t square. This is also looking like addition of two vectors. So ut vector is in this direction and half a t square vector is in this direction. Plug in the values, t is given as 1, u, the value of u is 2, so, and the value of a is 2. So similar to the argument what I have presented over here, here also you can find out the s vector, which is basically the addition of these two vectors. So what will be the magnitude? It will be root over ut whole square plus half into at square. So ut is 2 into 1, 2, and a is 2, so 2 by 2, 1, and t is anyway 1, so 1 square, so root 5 meters. Can you find the direction? Yes, let us call this angle beta. So beta will be tan inverse of opposite by adjacent. Opposite is 1 meter and adjacent is 2 meters. So it will be tan inverse of 1 by 2. Okay. Let's see the next one. velocity and acceleration of a particle at time t is equal to 0 are u vector is equal to 2y plus 3j and a vector is equal to 4i plus 2j meter per second square. Find the velocity and the displacement of the particle at t is equal to 2 seconds. So what is the difference between this sum and the previous sum what we have handled? In the previous models, you know, you have got this u is equal to directly 2 meter per second or 4 meter per second. That's magnitude. But here u has been presented as a vector. So whenever you see this type of thing, you have to use the vector format for solving the question. So a vector is given and u vector is given. So can we find v vector? V is equal to u vector plus at, right? So here everything you will get in terms of I and j. How do I identify whether it has been given in the vector format? Means it will be given in the format of I, j, k. If not, directly the magnitude is given. Okay, so 2i plus 3j is the u vector and a vector is 4i plus 2j. So when you multiply in the vector operation, a to t is simple multiplication. Okay, just a simple multiplication, and here you have to add all the I terms and the j terms. So when you finally do that, you get 10i plus 7j. So add all the single terms. X component should be added in the x direction, y component should be added in the y components, y direction. You cannot add I to j. Okay, so finally you get v vector is equal to 10i plus 7j. Similarly, if you want to get a displacement, s vector is equal to u vector into t plus half into a vector plus into t square. So u vector 2i plus 3j, time is given as 2 seconds, so t is equal to 2. A vector is given as this 4i plus 2j into 2 square. Here also you will add all the i's and all the j's. Finally you get 2i plus 10j. Okay. So students, note the difference between the previous type of question and this type of question. These are basic level questions, but they build your concepts. Often we come across one formula we have to remember. They often ask you what is the distance travelled in the nth second. Now let me define what is length a second. Let us say a person starts from point P and reaches Q. Okay, he takes n seconds. So what is the nth second means? Let us say this distance is 5 kilometers in n seconds. Not 5, you cannot go 5 kilometers in n seconds, right? Let us say this is 5 meters. Okay, 5 meters in 5 seconds. So, fifth second, what is the distance travelled means? So, you will, what is n minus 1? 4 seconds. In 4 seconds, he might have travelled this much distance. So, in the fifth second, he has travelled how much? This total distance minus this distance travelled in the n minus 1 second. So, this is the concept behind the nth second. So, there is a formula for that. You will just see the derivation. Let us say, we use the same formula, s is equal to ut plus half t square. So here prefix I am writing as Sn. Sn is equal to u t plus half at square. In the place of t, you have to put n. Sorry, it has to be n. Alright? And similarly, Sn minus 1. What is Sn minus 1? Distance, total distance travelled in n minus 1 seconds. So in the place of t, you have to put t minus 1. Right? If you put t, you get a total distance. If you put t minus 1, you get this much distance. So u into t minus 1 plus half into a into n minus 1 whole square. If you subtract these two, you get snth. Snth is equal to sn minus 1. Okay? If he says that in the last 2 seconds, what is the distance traveled, then you have to put t minus 2 in the equation. Okay? Simple. The procedure is this. So sn minus 1 when you do, it is Sn is u plus half into an. See here, you get un and sorry, this also has to be n. Okay? So here there is un minus of this term. It is un minus un minus 1. So un and cancel. What is left is u. That is what is written here. Okay? Plus half into this term minus this term. So take a common, it will be n square minus n minus 1 whole square. It is a minus b whole square, n square minus n square minus 1 by opening the bracket plus 2n. Okay, inside it will be minus 2n, so outside it has become plus 2n. So n square cancels and you are left with only minus 1 and 2n term. So 2n minus 1. So SNH is equal to u plus a by 2 into 2n minus 1. This is the formula you should remember. Whenever you are asked about questions, what is the distance travelled in the nth second? Okay. Remember the procedure, because they may ask you in the last 2 seconds. So if they ask you in the last 2 seconds, you have to do what? You have to put here Sn minus 2. Then you get some other formula. Then you get some other formula. But usually SNH is asked. Okay. Let's see one more example. A particle is projected vertically upwards with a velocity 40 meter per second. Find the displacement and distance travelled by the particle in 2 seconds, 4 seconds and 6 seconds. Take g is equal to 10 meter per second square. So the situation is like this. On the ground, a particle is projected upwards, vertically upwards, with a speed of 40 meter per second. Okay. So let us see what is the maximum height it travels and what is the time it takes. So the topmost point, the velocity will be 0, because it will reach the topmost point and then it will return back because of gravity. So acceleration will be equal to minus g. So in this first case, the velocity at the top point will be 0. So 0, v is equal to u plus at, u is given as 40. So 0 is equal to 40 minus 10 into t, g is equal to minus 10. So here you get t is equal to 4 seconds. That means it takes 4 seconds to reach to the topmost point. Now the first question says, what is the distance and displacement travelled in the first 2 seconds? So if you want to know what is the first 2 seconds, it will be s is equal to ut plus half at square. You have to put the value of t is equal to 2 here. Rest everything is in your, you already know, u is equal to 40. T is equal to 2, a is equal to minus g. So when you substitute here, you finally get 60 meters. So in the first 2 seconds, it has travelled a distance of 60 meters. That means from here to here it has reached. So in this case, the distance and displacement both are equal. Okay? In this case, the distance travelled is this, and the displacement also, this is initial position, this is final position. So displacement also is equal to 60 meters. Now, in the second situation, he has asked you about what happens after 4 seconds. So 4 seconds, we have already calculated, it reaches the topmost point. Alright? So we need to see what is the distance it travels. So in the equation, you have to put t is equal to 4. When you put t is equal to 4, s is equal to ut, 40 into 4 minus half 80 square, half into 10 into 4 square. You solve it, you get 80 meters. So in the first 4 seconds, it travels 80 meters from the ground. Even in this case also, the displacement is equal to distance, because it reached the maximum point. From here onwards, it will come back. But till that point, the displacement and distance will be equal. In the third question, he says, after 6 seconds, what is the distance and what is the displacement? Now see here. After 6 seconds means, first 4 seconds, it has reached up to here. So it will start falling down. So the next 2 seconds, it will fall down. So if you take the reference point as the topmost point, can I use s is equal to ut plus half at square? But here, at the topmost point, the velocity is 0. So you get s is equal to half at square, but a is equal to g here. Okay? So s is equal to half gt square. You put the value of t is equal to 2, you get 20 meters. That means it has fallen by 20 meters. Now, the distance and displacement will not be equal. The displacement will be 60 meters, because the object was thrown here, it went like this, right? And the present position is like this. So initial position, final position is this at the moment. So the displacement will be 60 meters. What is the distance means, it went from here, went up to here, and then it is right now here. So this distance plus this distance we have to add. This is already 80, 80 plus 20, it is 100 meters. Okay.